Viktors Dobrovsovs pēc spēles pret Rīgu, treneri, tavs komentārs.
Nu, pirmkārt, paldies, jāsaka, līdzjūtējiem jau var arī nosaukt par fanu grupiņu, kas dodas mums līdzi, un plus tur, cik es zinu, no Vācijas, Īrijas bija cilvēki. Laikam vecrīgā viņi satikās un ievilināja stadionā, tas ir labi būt tā vairāk, un tad mums arī vēl kuplākā skaitā būt cilvēki. Kas attiecās par pašu spēli, nu, skaidrs, ka mums bija cits taktiskais izvietojums. Mums bija vairāk jāciešās un sapratām, ka būs jāspēlē daudz bez bumbas, plus pārējot uz dabīgo laukumu, ka tas varētu mums būt kaut kāds sarežģījums, bet kopumā, nu, es varētu teikt, ka puiši strādāja labi un bez bumbas un pildīja to, ko mēs no viņiem prasījām.
Ņemot vērā, ka tā spēles manieri bija paredzama, vai neizskatīja iespēju Dudu uzlikt, kurš ir ātrāks, kurš var aizskriet šajos Skonto stadiona plašumos, vai tomēr kaut kur nospēlē arī tas vietējais leģionārs, ka vienmēr dosi priešrocību saviem auzēkņiem, kā šoreiz Rodrigo Gauča gadījumā?
Nu, nē, principā Gaučs arī bija pelnījis jau tur iepriekšējo spēli ātrāk spēlēt, bet viņam tur tad pustraumiņi bija, te nav svarīgi leģionārs vai tas. Un otrs faktors, nu, ka Dudu, kad ir tai pamatā, ne vienmēr, ko es teicu, tiem ārzemniekiem ir vajadzīgs tas laiks. Ne vienmēr viņš var iebraukt tajā, ko no viņa prasa. Un tāpēc, ja, kad jau uz beigām ir mazāk laika, vienalga vai, nu, pretinieks ne šajā gadījumā ir pagurs, tad viņam savu ātrumu vienkāršāk izmantot, jā, bet, nu, jā, līdzvērtīgi no pirmā minūtēm, tad vēl viņam tā pie tās spēļu disciplīnas ir jāpierod.
Kā kopumā vērtē, cik izdevās tas plāns, cik izdevās izturēt, vai tas, ka, piemēram, līdz otrā puslaika vidum bija 0-1, vai tas ir kaut kāds tāds mazā uzvariņa, ka bijāt tajā spēlē, varam arī atcerēties pirmā puslaika beigas, otrā puslaika sākuma, kad arī kaut kādi momenti radās, vai esi apmierinās ar to, ka bija varianti aizķerties kaut kādos brīžos?
Nu, to pierāda visas komandas, kas, principā, spēlē ar Rīgu, kad, ja, jo ilgāk ir 1-0 Rīgai pa labu, jo tas dod iespēju pēc tam tavai komandai, jo Rīga, nezinu, kāpēc, pārstāja spēlēt, sāk uztraukties pa saviem vārtiem, tad dod tev bumbu, un viņi, nu, tā ir viņa darīšana, jā, bet, nu, to mēs jau arī futbolisti saprot, jo ilgāk tu esi spēlē ar mazu rezultātu 0-1, jo tev ir kaut kādas izredzes, jā, izraukto punktiņu, varbūt arī, nezinu, laimes gadījumā uzvar.
Kārlis Mikuļskis, tāda kļūda, piedot tādas kļūdas, vai esi neapmierināts par pendulu?
Nu, kā te teikt, nu, es laikam skatoties čempionātu spēles, nu, es atradīšu katrā spēlē tādas divas pārkāpumas, nu, katrā. Nu, mūsu spēlē vienīgais, ko es vēlreiz saku, pret vaļiem, tāda pendela neviens nemaz tur, nu, okay, viņa bija, bet es vēl domāju, ka tur vēl vāri pastītos, ja būtu uz otru pusi tādu, vēl kādas 7 minūtes tur apstītos. Bet, protams, nu, viņš tur pielaida kļūdu, un diemžēl viņam tādas kļūdas ir, ka es nerunāju tikai soda laukumā ārpus, jā, drusku tā pozīcija un startā, kur pretinieks ieņem veiksmīgu pozīciju un viņam ir jātais pārkāpums. Es pat runāju tur čempionāta sākumus, tur, kur viņi noraidīja, it kā, jā. Tad vēl tādas epizodītas bija un tad plus šodienas.
Rupīgs, kuram tikai nesen 17 gadi apretē, bija jāspēlē pret virslīgas iespējams tehniskāku, ātrāku, nepatīkamāku uzbrucēju Daškeviču. Nu, pieļauju, ka īsti variantu tev daudz nebija, bet kādām domām, teiksim, pieņemot šo lēmumu, liekot viņu pamatsastāvā tajā flangā, zinot, kas būs pretī, kādi tie apsvērumi vai tās domas, prognozes tā no tādas puses?
Nu, šeit laikam mēs varētu atzīt, ka drusku es pielaidu kļūdu, jo vienā malā, kur es noliku Krišu un Roberts Meļķis, ja mēs, ja tu atceries, tad pēc ielaistiem vārtiem es tur uzreiz pamainīju, un Roberts sāk vidū spēlēt, ja? Tad tā kļūda laikam bija, kad, nu, tomēr Robertam nav spēcīgākā īpašība spēlēt, un plus jaunais Krišs, tātad tas tāds, nu, Krišs bija pamests drusku zem tanka, tāpēc ātri, nu, būtu labāk pirms golu uz to noreģējis un pamainījis, lai tāpēc ielika halatu, kurš tomēr vairāk viņam palīdz. Ja? Ja pa pašu Krišu, es jau teicu vienā no preses konferencēm, ka viņš tiks pie savu laiku, jo viņš labi sev pierādīja pirmssezonā ar skaidrs ar visām kuplo spēļu skaitu šī mēneša nogriezdī, ka viņš tiks, viņš sev labi pierādīja. Ne tikai tāpēc, kad varbūt kādam traumu un viņš tiek. Un plus vēlreiz, es jau pieminēju, viņš ir U17 bija pamatsastāvu spēlētājs un spēlēja pa aizsargu. Un te viņam ir tā iespēja, kur izmantot, teiksim, nevis savu šansu, bet uzkrāt pieredzi šajās spēlēs. Un, teiksim, ja tieši konkrēti šajā spēlē, nu, tas satraukums viņu laikam tur tā pirmo puslaiku drusku tā purināja, bet nu, puslaikā es viņam saku, ja tu nespēlēsi droši vienalga, tā ir U18-3. Līga, un šodien pret Rīgu, ja tu nemēģinās spēlēt, kā tu māki, tad tev nebūs nekāda progresa. Nu, tad otrā puslaikā, nu, pēc manām domām, ka viņš diezgan pielikās un labi aizvedīja.
Pirms maču interviju Rudolfu Meļķi, kurš atzinās, ka ne tikai nekad nav spēlējis Skonto stadionā, bet pat nekad nav bijis kā līdzeties šajā stadionā. Jautājums varbūt citreiz pirms mačiem lielās arēnās kādā ekskursijā aizvest, lai pierod pie tās atmosfēras pie laukuma.
Nu tas...
Uz izlases maču.
Jā, te it kā ir tas tāda humora sastāvdaļa, bet tas nozīmē, ka tiem jauniem spēlētājiem ir jāinteresējās par futbolu, un man liekas, tu vienā intervijā tur pārmet kādam futbolistam, jā, kad. Tas tomēr, tas rāda, protams, viņam patīkams šodien bija diena, viņš ieradās trīs tribīnes, un viss labi, bet tomēr, nu, tiem jauniešiem, kad saka, pa ekskursiju, nē, bet, nu, viņiem pašiem arī būtu jāierodās kadrei, vienalga, kā līdzjūtējiem apmeklēt stadionu.
Coach, please, your commentary about this match.
Yes, thank you. Very professional and good and important win. Very happy with the clean sheet. Very happy how we reacted after last match. And as I said, what our boys did today, it was very, very professional and happy with that.
Jā, ļoti profesionāli un svarīgi uzvara. Esmu ļoti priecīgs, ka neielaidām vārds un ļoti svarīgi arī, kā spējām profesionāli reaģēt pēc iepriekšējās spēles.
After this big Riga derby, the squad selection and particularly Kirill Siljins on right side, what were the principles of selecting the squad today?
Yeah, of course the principles were how we can pick the best starting 11 for this match, that's always the principle. But of course, we have played already a lot of games in a short period of time, so needed to kind of a little bit refresh some areas of our, you know, starting lineup. And at the same time, we are now start getting the players who have been injured kind of long time, little bit in out, like a Pekka came in now in, Brian Peña coming in, you know, we have start getting those players who are not anymore this half of it, you know, not, you know, they are start getting now, you know, more and more, you know, match fitness, and now we have maybe more options, you know, to rotate, but to play Kira on the right, we needed, you know, this fullback to come in to make a, like a double six, you know, two pivots, you know, the building up, and at the same time to track, attract, you know, more space for our wingers to run behind the line, and it worked, you know, a couple of moments it worked very well, and that was idea to bring left-footed players on the right that he can come on inside on his right foot, and a couple of dangerous crosses, even one shot, you know, he went in there. So that was the idea behind that.
About goalkeepers, of course, there is also competition and rotation is a normal thing, but usually coaches don't like or don't do this, that changing one game by one goalkeepers. Yeah. Why are you doing so?
Yeah, yeah, and as you said, it mostly it's a competition, and goalkeeper position for me, it's not that much different than other positions. That we went it for Matrevic for RFS game, and thinking that there would be a lot of crosses, thinking that, but there was not that many crosses in this match, and then to concede a couple of goals, then I felt it now again, as we needed that match to change something, we needed for this match to help Purins with our build up with his feet, and he was you know, very good, you know, with his feet, and he almost gives us like a third center back when we're building up, so that was the reason.
And first starting 11 for Musia and for Kamelon Gena, these two players, maybe you can separately to talk about them, how they played today.
Yeah, Muskia, as we always know, when you come from South America, maybe the adaptation period, it will take time. At the same time, club like Riga FC, there is no time to adapt. And he has been working very hard, but at the same time, we have had players who have played, you know, midfield and have been happy what they have been doing. But now was the right moment to bring him in. And what he brings to our team, I like this positive energy what he has. He has a lot of, you know, this, he wants to challenge the opponent. He wants to go hard on these duels. He really wants to play for the team. So to have him here and get to know first start for him and see that, you know, he can play you know, different position, as he started as a six, then later on when we needed to take Joic out, he played even a little bit higher, and it was a good mix what we had it there. And then who was that to play? Pekka? That player who did say first start?
Gena, Kamelon Gena.
Yellow card?
And first time it was Gena,
Kamelon Gena,
who scored
the
goal.
Oh, but I think he started. Sorry. He started the Super Cup, and I was thinking that he must have started, you know, something, you know. So, but
about this league. Yeah.
Okay. We have really missed him because after the start of the season, he got little injury, you know, couple of places, and he has not kind of get, you know, himself fit. But again, big credit to Pekka, how he has been working. He has been playing a couple of games for the second team, getting his match fitness, and now what he is showing in the training, it was the right time to put him on, and he showed on the field very, very important goal, almost assist, you know, get the penalty, and other moments he had it there. So I'm very happy again to get him closer, you know, to his peak level.
And one bigger question, probably we have talked about this, but still, in these 10 games, Riga just once has scored more than two goals. Mm. With Liepāja, 4-0, but other games it's one or two goals, not that much. We remember last year there were some 5-1, some bigger wins. About this attacking, for me, today's game against Grobiņa was perfect time to try score more, because opponent is from lower table and they were like more defensive and without also some players injured. And for me, when result was 1-0, not every time Riga played fast, not every time looked at the opponent goal, but just slow passing between central defenders, also on your half of the pitch. Do you see also this as a topic to talk, or you want the team controls the ball, plays this ball possession football and not that vertical?
Always very nice to talk about the football, and it's a good topic to talk, and as you said it, you know, there is no right or wrong way to play football, and what we try to do it, we try to control the game with and without the ball, and sometimes in our process where we are now, maybe sometimes we do not recognize, you know, the moments when we could hurt opponent more. But how this league works, if you start playing vertical football and you start going very fast, every time there, the ball will come even faster back to you, and then it's a problem. So we need to find this pausa of the tempo to do it. Sometimes we need to slow the game down to be able to go fast. If it's 100 all the time, bam, 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 it's impossible to play, especially if you play every after 3 days. It's impossible. That's why we need to find this different variation of the tempo. Is there a lot of things that we want to improve? Yes, 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 yes. Do we need to score more goals? Yes, of course. Did it look today for you that we did not want to score? Yes, we did want to score. Actually, I think we are creating enough, but at the same time, I feel we should even create more quality chances, not the quantity chances that we get, you know, there. We should get even better positions that the scoring goals would come easier. And then, of course, you mentioned the opponent, you know, they came maybe with the injuries or something, but they played their heart out, you know, try to...
Grobiņa is good counter-attacking team for you?
We have seen it, you know, this 9 first round, they have been there, but I don't know, was it because of the missing some players, playing first time on the grass or something, we did not let them anything. I see more, it was our players, what they did on the field, we did not let them, you know, to go for the counter-attack. But if you analyze the Grobiņa, it has been very good, their strength. And Grobiņa, their strength, I really like how they play. They have identity, they can pass, they can keep the ball, get the opponent out and then play. Or they have this option, they defend, they leave always, you know, 2-3 players ready for the counter-attacks and then they go. And that's why I said I was very pleased how our performance was today, that we did not let, you know, those moments to happen.